lot of people, you know, they look at me and they're like, you're crazy. I would never go up there. You know, it's dangerous.
The physical and mental challenge of the sport, of trying to push yourself as far as you can go to achieve the summit.
Considered one of the top female high-altitude mountain climbers in the world, Christine Boskoff has tackled more summits than any woman alive. Her partner, Charlie Fowler, is among the best-known mountaineers in the United States.
They were great partners. And that lifestyle that they were in, your partner is really meaningful.
Summit or die. It's a famous quote from the Japanese, and you might have to.
Their last camp before the summit.
Both set out for the treacherous border region between Nepal and southwest China in October. They were last heard from on November 9th.
Rescuers in China's Sichuan province have said that they have located the body of one of two American mountain climbers.
What she had was an incredible love of mountains. Chris, she wanted to touch them. She wanted to be on them. She wanted to be absorbed in them. Needed to be in that environment, like up close and personal, on rocks, on glaciers, in, you know, around crevasses, everything. Just insatiable desire to be part of those mountains.
The thing that really intrigues me about climbing is not only the venture of the excitement and the danger of climbing, but it's also going into a different land and seeing the people and experiencing their culture.
Charlie was an inspiration to a ton of people.
He was one of the greatest climbers in the world. You know, he's climbed more things and done more first descents. He was technically just awesome. But he wasn't cocky, he wasn't, you know, his motto was the more the merrier. We would take people climbing with us. It didn't make any difference if you've ever climbed a day in your life.
His stories, if you could get him to start telling stories, they were amazing, and the things he's done in his life.
Chris was the first woman I saw Charlie spend time with that was on par with him in terms of athletics, climbing ability, and just sheer sense of adventure. You don't get that opportunity to be close to exceptional people like that.
But she loved that climbing, you know. From the very top of Mount Everest, from our solar telephone, she called, Mom, I made it and I'm on top of the world. And that's where she was, and she was so happy.
She wanted to pick up mountain madness from Scott Fischer, who had died during the 1996 Everest disaster, and run it as a business that could be profitable enough in order to help her in getting out and climbing all over the world. She was successful in that. She'd climbed a number of the, you know, the big 8,000 meter peaks. That should have given her a great brand recognition, but she was a very, very humble person.
Chris and Charlie were always looking for something new. I mean, once Chris chose to no longer pursue the big 8,000 meter peaks, I think her focus changed to going sort of after the uncharted climbs. Technically, the climbing is harder, so it's just a different game, and I think it's more true to the spirit of climbing.
We were expecting Chris back on December the 7th, but the plane arrived and she didn't.
And Damon called me and said, Charlie and Chris didn't make the flight. And that's kind of when we sort of went into action.
We weren't exactly sure where they were.
Nobody knew. And it was a real hunt